Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, Trials and Tribulations. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we finally brought the trial to its conclusion, and I kinda bummed out that it was Godo that was the ultimate murderer in this case. For, like I said at the end of last episode, for better or for worse, he did it to protect Maya from being killed herself, but once he made that decision, it was always inevitable that either Pearls or Misty Faye was going to be murdered at that point. So, like I said, my sympathy only goes so far. He essentially shanked one of them. He shanked Misty Faye in the back at the end of the day. Whether he knew or not he was doing it, who can say. But Maya's still alive, which is good. Iris got off not guilty, which is fantastic, because I don't know, I actually ship Iris and Phoenix. I don't know, but it seemed like a good couple. Iris is a really nice nice young lady, and Phoenix is a bit of a... Well, he said that he believed in Iris. Like, he thought it was Dahlia, correct, but the Dahlia that Iris was presenting, which was essentially Iris herself, so... I don't know, I kind of ship it. I hope in future that we get happiness together, but of course she's in jail. Anyway, let's get stuck into the final episode of this game and go through all the epilogue stuff and see how everything gets wrapped up in a nice little bow. Where's my confetti, man? There's always confetti and cheering. What a poopy game. February 10th, 4:51 p.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 1. So I guess it's all over. The way everything ended was justice really served. The man who risked his life to save Meyer is being sent to prison by my own hand.
Of course, justice was served.
Every end of every freaking game, this bloody song! Stop it, it hurts! Mia!
I'm proud of you, Phoenix. Your defense was truly brilliant.
But I couldn't save Mr. Armando. The man who cared so deeply for you.
You're wrong, Phoenix. You did save Diego. You saved him in the only way possible.
You mean, with that verdict?
I think one day, you'll understand too. Phoenix, I want you to remember one thing. You're as good out there today as any defense lawyer could ever hope to be. There's nothing more you can learn from me.
But Mia...
You've accomplished something I wasn't able to. I owe you a great deal. Thank you.
Mia.
I'm sure we'll meet again someday, Phoenix.
I've had lots of cases and seen a lot of things. But along this journey, I found myself asking just one question. What does it really mean to defend someone? I suppose today's case produced one possible answer. But Maya...
I guess it's just like my sis said.
Your sister, Mia.
That night, when I channeled Mia to get her advice on what to do, this is what she wrote back in my notebook. Don't worry, Phoenix will save everyone in the end.
But...
Come on, cut it out with that gloomy face! Can't you see? Me, sis, and I'm sure Iris too. We owe you for everything you've done for us, Nick.
Maya, how can you be so bright and chipper after all that's happened? You were brutally attacked, and even saw your mother murdered. No! But Francisca!
Still as softy as always, Phoenix Wright.
And Edgeworth! Excellent work, right?
Mr. Edgeworth! When did you get back?
Oh, that's right. Well, I guess no one filled her in on that. He defended the case as well, Maya. Andrew and Francisco have actually been helping me.
Helping you?
If these two aren't meeting her on the first day of a trial, the defense wouldn't have gotten anywhere.
Wow! But where were you, Nick? I heard he sailed into a river and caught a nasty cold, which forced him to sleep all day.
Yes, he laid in bed shivering from his fever with Iris's hood pulled over his head.
Oh, ouch! Talk about embarrassing, Nick. You definitely need more training. Anyway, thank you, Mr. Edgeworth. And you too, Francisca.
I don't suppose.
Oh, bloody Larry.
I don't suppose there's room for me in Miss Groupog, is there?
Oh, Larry. What's with the longer than usual face?
What's with a longer than usual face?
I realized something when I was reborn. I realized that Larry was never of any use to anyone. Not even once.
But that's not true, right, Nick?
What? You're asking me?
Well, Nick, is it true? I've got a place in this world, right?
Yeah, of course.
I knew it. Everyone would be better off if I were gone for good.
No. Oh, yeah. Those portraits you painted, they were really good. Isn't that right, Edgeworth?
What? But me?
Why are you making my face, huh, Edgy?
Yes, indeed. I certainly can't say that it's lacking resemblance.
Do you really mean it? What about you, Fancy? Did I draw you well, too?
She's gonna be brutal as...
My beauty can't possibly be captured by a mere crayon.
No!
Nevertheless, I recognize the effort you put into it, and that's worth something.
Francisca scared of Maya? Oh, really? That's just funny to me.
So then you'll do it, like you promised? Now I'm gonna model for my next picture book, Francis Whiplash.
Don't get carried away!
That would be a very painful course, I'd imagine.
Well, how about that? I guess painting portraits is the only thing I'm good at. The painting of Pearl was pretty darn good too, if you ask me.
Huh? Now that you mention it, I haven't seen her around.
Pearls? Who could she have gone? Not me, she would have made a beeline for Maya.
Oh, I'll go look for her. Be right back.
Where's Morgan? Oh, dear.
Hey, Pearly!
Right. You seem to be uncharacteristically puzzled. I suspect you are wondering how Maya can be so cheerful despite all that has happened.
Yeah.
To be honest, I can't understand it either.
Ziska. That's right, she lost her father fairly recently as well.
I think I understand how she feels. Maya is a much wiser person than she appears. And I think she realizes something.
Bloody hell, everyone here has lost their parents. I mean, Edgeworth's dad got brutally murdered. Francisca's dad got sentenced to death. And now Maya's mother has been brutally murdered. This is horrifying.
Now is exactly the time when she needs to be as strong as she can.
What do you mean by now is exactly the time?
Maya wasn't the only one that was badly wounded by this incident. In fact, there was someone that was hurt far more deeply than she. I believe it's for that person that Maya is trying her best not to cry.
Someone who was hurt more deeply than Maya.
Pearls. Her mum tried to get her to kill her own family.
Edgeworth. I think I'm starting to understand too.
Ah! But tell me, Phoenix Wright, who is Maya Fee being strong for?
Is it Pearls or Godo?
Perfect.
Poor kid. After all, the reason that she worked so hard to follow the instructions was because she loved and believed in her mother and Morgan. It's for the good of the Fae clan. I'm sure that she believed in every last word. She thought she was doing it for Maya. That's why she was so happy. Shows how truly devoted she is to Maya.
But it's a cruel irony that it was her exuberance that led to this tragedy. Maya Fey's mother was killed, and Maya herself was put into the deepest peril imaginable.
That's exactly why Maya is putting on a brave face. She's doing it for Pearl's sake, till she can see her smile again.
Uh-oh.
Oh, hey! So this is where you all were. Wow, looks like we've got quite a bunch here today. Yeah! What was that for, sir?
Sorry about that, Scruffy. My VIP just seems to have a mind of its own.
What's up, Detective Gumshoe? Oh, you know, this and that. Anyway, congrats on your win. The squad's not, pal. Dinner's on me.
Can you afford it with all the pay cuts you get?
My salary's just sort of kind of gone down by a teeny weeny bit. But it's alright. I made reservations at a first class French restaurant tonight. Oh no. Oh no. Trebian's got terrible food. Ugh.
Pretty good work, Scruffy. That fit was your reward.
Detective Gumshoe. You said a first class French restaurant. You don't mean... Trebian, where else? I knew it. We're doomed. Come on, let's go, everyone. Can't keep Maggie waiting, pal. Oh, of course. Hey, you, crybaby. You're invited too.
Oh, forget about me. Pearl and I will be at the loser's shack eating potatoes.
You know, Myra's taken an awfully long time to get back. She's still not looking for pearls. Oh, Maya, what's wrong?
Nick, what do I do? Pearly, I can't find her anywhere.
Huh? I'll bet she just went back home. That's all.
I thought so too, so I called the village. But no one has heard from her. This has never happened before.
As I figured, she's been badly hurt by this incident. She feels responsible for the tragedy that has befallen you, Maya.
But, none of this was her fault. What should I do?
Detective Gumshoe. Yeah, what is it, pal? You guys go on ahead. But what about you? Mara and I will join you guys once we find pearls.
Nick!
Don't worry about us, Detective Gumshoe. Maybe a little late, but we'll definitely be there. We have a lot of celebrating to do tonight, and I wouldn't miss it for the world. Yeah, but you're there.
Very well, Phoenix Wright. Better go on ahead.
Is she just scared of all the people here?
Don't keep us waiting, right?
We won't.
But where should we look? Where could Pearly have gone?
Let's go, Maya. There's only one place that I can think of that Pearls might have gone to.
Is it the office? Oh, back up here. Hazakura Temple.
Hazakura Temple?
For Pearls, I bet this is a very important place. After all, it's where this whole incident started.
What's this? You're all back again so soon.
Sister
Bikini, I thought we'd be eating mashed potatoes alone tonight. So she's here. Pearly's here. She's in the training hall. Why don't you hurry along and go see her? Okay. Pearly's not here.
Maya, the hanging scroll.
Is it been replaced?
Someone clean it off.
It's gotta be pearls.
Yeah, Mystic Maya. But Pearly, why? Why did you just leave like that? Mystic Maya.
Oh.
I swore that I would never trouble the two of you ever again. Because it's all my fault that Mystic Maya's mother.
That's why you came here.
It's the least I could do. To pray for your happiness. You don't have to do that, Pearly. It wasn't your fault. You didn't do anything wrong. Of course, I'm sad that my mother is gone. But how do I say this? I'm still happy. You don't have to lie just to make me feel better. No, really. It's true. The only reason I'm still here at all is thanks to everyone who was there for me. My sis, my mother, Mr. Armando, Nick, and you. If even one of you weren't there, I'm sure I wouldn't still be alive right now. That's why I have to be strong for all the people that were there for me when I needed them. That's all I can really do. Mystic Maya. I'm impressed. You truly have a daughter of Mystic Misty.
Sister
Bikini! Your mother was Mystic Misty. Was a strong woman indeed. I want to tell you what she said to me that night. after dishonoring the good name of Crane. I don't have a right to face my daughter. But still, Maya is always in my thoughts. It's true. She'll always be with me until the day I die.
Your spirit was with her. That's why your mother was so strong. Even at the end, I'm sure she had no regrets.
She'll always be with me until the day I die, huh? There's a rule or something all masters are to follow, isn't there? To never take the charm off until the day you die.
Professor Master's talisman.
The thing that Misty kept by her heart and would never take off. It wasn't the container that was important. Rather, it was the contents.
That's...
It'd be a picture of the me or am I, wouldn't it?
A photo?
Ah! Mother.
It's only natural for living creatures to fight to protect their own lives. But what makes us human is that we fight for others. But who do you fight for? How hard must you fight? That's the true measure of what human life is worth. We defense attorneys are warriors who are constantly challenged by that question.
How many times is that vase going to get broken? It's so adorable.
Even when the battle is over, and the bonds that connect us are severed, we always return, time and time again. Mia, Maya, Pearls, Mr. Armando, and Maya's mother too. I learned that from all of them. Well, shall we get going? Everyone is waiting.
Ah.
This is a day to remember. A day when a lot of things are finally put to rest. I think we should celebrate what we've overcome today.
I still can't.
Oh, go on, sweetie. You can't come back for training any time.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna make a brand new start too. Sister Bikini, I'll be back for more training, I promise.
I know, and I won't go easy on you just because you're the future master. I'll make sure to prepare reservations for free for when you come back.
And can someone please put Morgan Fay in an isolated cell for the rest of her life? She's evil.
Alright, we're gonna have a great feast today, Pearlie. You know why? Because training is a battle of endurance.
Okay, Mystic Maya, I'll eat lots and lots of food tonight.
You know, there's one thing I don't get. Probably don't want to, but...
What is it, Nick?
Reservations for training is fine and all, but why for free?
Come on, what do you think? You're one of us, Nick. Next time you can train right alongside us.
Dude, it fell in a river and it got a cold.
I'll be waiting for you. Sister Bikini will take special care of you.
It'll be great, Nick. We're gonna do the special course naturally.
That's a great idea. After all, Mr. Nick, you'd do anything for Mr. Maya, wouldn't you? Even walk on her clothes, right?
Well, have a nice big meal before we come next time, right, Nick?
You know, I was wondering if I can say just one little thing.
Sure, of course you can. Oh, I love this part. I can't wait to hear it.
I'm getting goosebumps, too.
Well then, here goes nothing.
To work extra hard now. Master of Crane and the office manager of Ryan and Cole law offices. And I have to be a good big sister to Pearlie and Nick too. Well, as long as I'm not locked up or captured or something like that.
Every damn game.
There is true. Mr. Nick really is Mystic Maya's knighting shining armor. He went through with his special course, all the way to the end. Actually, I heard there's a legendary extra special archer course here too. I think I'll surprise the two of them by making them a secret reservation.
Please, Pearls, no. We want to live forever. We don't want to die on this mountain along with everyone else. I got a new jacket. I don't like it.
Mind you bought me a new coat, pal. I feel 10 years younger. I'll never take it off.
Yes, but somehow you just don't seem the same. I guess a dirty, shabby old overcoat is just more detective-like, sir.
Don't worry about it. In the name of love, a man will soil himself silly.
I don't like it. I want the green one back. It is a cool jacket, though.
Mr. Wright, I am once again in your debt. Thanks to you, the Treasures of Crane exhibit was a great success. I even got to see Miss Von Karma, who I had not seen for almost a year. She taught me how to use a whip and said that I must show you what I've learned.
Uh-oh. That's all we need, two characters with whips.
Desi and I started a company called Masty Mass Consulting.
We're dedicated to stopping the evil plans of all the criminals in the city.
Our motto is, cut it out, please.
Pretty cute, huh?
Well, we also sell plans to the criminals as a kind of... I wonder if that's okay. Sometimes I think maybe we're the worst criminals.
And he can't be tried for being Masty Mass because he's already been tried and found innocent. Oh dear.
Mr. Wright, I want to thank you for... exterminating Don Tigre. I have returned the $500,000 along with a tea set. A special Vic tea, one I mixed with my own two hands. I bet he's drinking it now. Win through compromise.
No problem, darling. God, you've got to read these first, haven't you?
It really sneaks up on you.
Oh no. I'm just told and in the way. A wrinkly, grumpy clown knows the waste of flesh. At least, that's what I thought. But my grandkids had a birthday party for me the other day. Talk about embarrassing. 69 years old and I cried like a baby with a dirty diaper.
I love these things that are going for all the characters. I'm not doing any post-game commentary because I'm obviously doing these.
As usual, we have an abundance of work to do. We've hired a new programmer to replace Glenn Elk. I do hope everyone will get along. His name is Aramada. As soon as I heard his name, I knew our brain circuits would align perfectly.
Aramada? What is that supposed to be, like, I don't matter or something? Goddamn global corporations.
My. More reporters. Since the murder, we've made so much money, I hardly know what to do. I think for magazines like us, because I provide such a nice visual, especially in spring. I can hardly wait for it to go, Iris to come back.
Yeah, she'll only have I think for the circumstances, she'll have a pretty short sentence. Okay, is it going to go for all the credits now? No, it's still going to go. Iris.
You've turned into such a respectable man, Feeny. It was so sweet of you and everyone else to come and visit me here the other day. Of course, I was happy that you constantly had your eyes on me, but... I felt kind of bad when the little one slapped you so hard you got a nosebleed.
Oh, Pearls. Oh, I do kind of ship Iris and Phoenix. Iris is such a nice lass, isn't she? Oh, the voice cast. Do I know anyone? Probably not. I think it was like... I don't really know many of these voice actors, I think. If any come up, I'll... And the song is brilliant. I think the sound design in this game has been fantastic. I mean, it's definitely better than the second one. And he throws his coffee. Oh no.
It's me, Winston Payne.
Oh no.
What's this? I'm back from a long, untiring vacation and no one is here to greet me.
I guess while I was gone, my little whippersnapper buddy quit. And now I've got no one. And what kind of lonely, crazy security room is this supposed to be anyway? What with all the flashing lights and switches, I feel like some sort of space alien. And now what I'm going to do with all these macadamia nuts around? I'll bring them up to Jipu, I know exactly what is on. I really can't accept these, I'm afraid of everything. Oh, don't worry, when I have a funny gentleman or treat me like... That's how I get...
Oh, buddy, you can't have a game without our bag. Jesus, I knew she was the lead of a security room. I think there was something on hiding whether to put her in.
I finally found something I love to do. Francis Whiplash Splash is gonna turn the art world on its head. Should have realized it sooner. Self-centered, lazy, antisocial. I'm an artist. A really good portrait artist. I'm not a loser after all.
God damn it, Lara. I hope it works out for you, but no doubt in a future game you'll be doing something completely different. Oh god, happy image gonna make me tear up. Please, no. I just want to sit and look, man. It's... You know... Is this done now? Capcom, you did a really, really good job with this trilogy, I'm not going to lie. Really, really, really enjoyed it. And you know, I was really nervous when I was going through the trials of this game that it was going to be... Because I always knew that the trilogy was sort of Phoenix Wright's main story. And there's a whole bunch of other games. I was concerned that... It wasn't going to give you the closure. It was just going to be essentially a whole bunch of weaker trials. Not to say that trials weren't fun, but I just think when you compare them with the likes of the first game and the early ones in the second game, there's a lot more believability in those games. In this game, it started to get a bit out of hand, I think. I thoroughly enjoyed them, though, and... One thing that I thoroughly enjoyed is the way this game wrapped up, particularly the end of the last trial. How they use songs so well in this game. So once you finally corner Godo and you present your last piece of evidence, it uses the pursuit track from the first game to symbolise that you come in full circle. And that you're using Maya's first piece of advice she ever gives you, thinking outside the box. And then once you come out, it gives you the turnabout sister's theme. And that song gets me every time. I love that song to pieces. It's just... I think from a story point of view, all the old trials had their own purpose for bringing this trilogy to a close. And I really appreciated that. Like, it harkened back to Godo's problems with colour in the kitchen trial with the El Tigre. And it did that a few times for some of the other trials as well. And for me, that just wrapped it up in a handbasket so well. It put the ribbon on it for me. And this trilogy and this game as well, absolutely fantastic. I think the sound engineering in terms of the music, the second game, I was kind of bummed out because I think the songs in the first game are so strong. It's subjective, of course, but I loved the songs in the first game and the second ones didn't quite... The ones in the second game didn't quite match up to it for me. But this game, I really got on board with some of them. I think this is definitely the second best game in terms of songs. But I think we've done that so once you get to the end, it uses songs from the first game. It's got more impact. And it definitely did. I was fighting a tear in the corners of my eyes as I was, like, closing the case and going through the end there. So, but, yeah, a fantastic trilogy and... One thing to say is I watched the first two games played by Nico B a while ago. I didn't watch this one, so I had no idea what to expect towards the end. But there's a difference between watching a game being played and listening to an idiot like me commentate over it and playing the game yourself. And if you're interested in playing this game, I strongly advise that you do because... Playing this game yourself, I feel like I've gone through the story myself. I've controlled the pace. And really, I've really enjoyed the soundtrack of the game. That's the strongest point for me, the story and the soundtrack. But yeah, that's not the end of the Ace Attorney series, though. I will be doing some of the others as well. I know Miles has got his own set of games. Edgeworth, sorry. And there's some others as well, so it will be coming back, but...
It just definitely feels like the first three games, these ones, they're done now. And it makes me kind of sad because it feels like I've been on a journey. It's taken me years to get through it on my channel. And it really bums me out. I mean, Phoenix Wright is probably the first game I did voices on. So if you go watch episode one of the first game and this episode, you'd see that the voices I do are way different. So I think I've been on a journey myself doing this as a Let's Play as well. But that's neither here nor there. All I can do now is end the series here, because I think waffling on is just going to needlessly prolong this video. And we'll move on to something else after we've finished this. Who knows what it could be, but I hope you'll tune in to watch it regardless. Anyway, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next series.